Good morning, students. This is Arvind, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, University of Kerala. In the previous class, I discussed about magnetic material properties and applications. So, in that context, I discussed about hysteresis losses and eddy current losses of magnetic material. And before that, I discussed about AC operation of magnetic circuits. Okay, and magnetic energy EMF and force concept. And in this class, I'm going to discuss last concept of this. First part, that is magnetic material properties and applications, that is a permanent magnet and its applications. And after that, I will start the second part of the unit one, that is principles of electromechanical energy conversion. Okay, so firstly, I will start with the permanent magnet concept. So the permanent magnet is an important excitation source. Commonly employed for imparting energy to magnetic circuits used in rotating machines. The permanent magnet is an important excitation source commonly employed for imparting energy to magnetic circuits used in rotating machines. There are three types of permanent magnets. One is anodes, and the second one is ceramics or ferrites, and third one is rare earth materials. So firstly, I will start with the this one anodized magnets used in motors up to 200 kilowatts, and the ceramic magnets are most economical in fractional kilowatt motors. Okay, the rare earth materials are very costly but are most economic choice in very small motors. So the latest addition is neodymium iron borate, that is NDFEBE. Okay, neodymium iron borate. Okay. Coming to the applications of permanent magnet materials, that is permanent magnets have greater applications in many small devices such as loudspeakers, AC and DC motors, microphones, analog electric meters, driving radio antennas, air conditioners, etc. So here we are taking the four types of ferromagnetic materials, those are ceramic, metallic, types of materials, that is A, B, C, D. In A type we have ceramic, and B type we have metallic, and C type also we have metallic, and D type we have, and in the D type we have rare earth. So coming to the material for this type, we have barium or strontium ferrite carbonate powders in the ceramic A type material, and in the coming to the B type, that is the metallic, in this one we have the material, that is Archimax. And coming to the C type, that is the metallic, we have Icomax. And coming to the D type, that is a rare earth, it consists of Sumerium cobalt material. So in this one we have the BR value, that is 0.39 for type A, and HC value is for the 200 for the type A ceramic, and BH maximum value for the type A ceramic, that is 30, and rho, that is the relative permeability value of this one, that is a high for the type A ceramic. And coming to the B type, that is metallic, in this one we have Archimax material. So for that one we have BR, HC and BH maximum value, and rho value is 1.25, 60, 45 and 500. And coming to the C type, that is the metallic, it consists of the material, that is Hyco maximum. For that one we have the BR, HC, BH maximum, and the rho value, that is 0.800. 335 and 500. And coming to the B type, that is rare earth, it consists of the material, that is sumerian cobalt, that is that consists of the values for BR, XC and BH maximum and rho is 0.75, 600, 130 and 60 respectively. Okay, next, ferromagnets have greater applications in many small devices such as loudspeakers, AC and DC motors, microphones, analog electric motors, driving, radio antennas, and air conditioners, etc. I already discussed this. In these applications, we are using these permanent magnet materials. Okay. Next, coming to the second part of this unit 1, that is principles of electromechanical energy conversion. Okay. So, an electromechanical energy conversion device is the device, okay, the electromechanical energy conversion device is the device that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy, electrical energy into mechanical energy, or mechanical energy into electrical energy. That means this is used as either generator or motor. You know already generator function. So generator, what means the generator? The generator is a device that is used to convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy. And similarly, the motor. So the motor is a device which is used to convert the electrical energy into mechanical energy. Okay. So the electromechanical energy conversion takes place via the medium of a magnetic field or an electric field. Okay. But most practical converters use magnetic field as the coupling medium between electrical and mechanical systems. Okay. Most practical converters use magnetic field as the coupling medium between electrical and mechanical systems. So this is because the electric storing capacity of the magnetic field is much higher than that of the electric field. Okay, why? Because the electric storing capacity of the magnetic field is much higher than that of the electric field. So electromechanical energy converters are either gross motion devices such as microphones, loudspeakers, electromagnetic relays, and certain electrical measuring instruments, etc. Electromechanical energy converters are either gross motion devices such as microphones, loudspeakers, electromagnetic relays, and certain electrical measuring instruments, etc. So, next we will discuss the why we need these electromechanical energies. Okay, so mechanical energy is normally used to do useful work for a car, truck, train, or aircraft to move. Mechanical energy input is needed to turn wheels or to push air behind it. And for electric trains and cars, that energy is supplied by the electric grid. So for electric trains and cars, that energy is supplied by the electric grid. Okay, this is the need of electromechanical energies. And next, in this one, electromechanical energy conversion. So electromechanical energy conversion, however, we mean either the conversion of electric energy into mechanical energy or vice versa. So in either conversion, we can use another system to convert, that is field system, another system to convert, that is field system. So normally the field is magnetic field. Normally the field is magnetic field. So coming to the block diagram of electromechanical energy conversion system, that is, so this is the hierarchy of the electromechanical system. So this electromechanical system consists of electrical system, mechanical system. In between we have one magnetic system. Okay. So in electrical system we have voltages and currents, and in the mechanical system we have speed and acceleration and position. Okay. So in the magnetic system we have magnetic flux, and in the voltages and currents we have circuit equations obtained by KVL and KCL. Those are the Kirchhoff's laws. KVL means Kirchhoff's voltage law and KCL means Kirchhoff's current law. And in the magnetic flux we have EMF or force of torque, and these are applied to the mechanical system, that is, it contains force of torque equations by Newton's law. Newton's laws. Okay, this is the hierarchy of the electromechanical system. Okay. And coming to electromechanical energy conversion devices. So here small motion of energy conversion devices we use. Small motion of energy conversion devices we use. Those are examples. For those small motion of energy conversion devices, those are telephones, receivers, microphones, etc. And we have linear motion of energy conversion devices. Example for those devices are electromagnetic relays, circuit breakers, etc. And third one, that is continuous motion of energy conversion device, continuous motion of energy conversion device. For example, for those devices are motors, generators, etc. Motors, generators, etc. Next, coming to the principle. Coming to the principle, that is, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but could be transferred from one form to another. This is the principle. So energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but could be transferred from one form to another, that is from electrical energy to mechanical or mechanical energy to electrical. So here we are taking energy transfer equations, that is electrical energy input from sources, that is equal to mechanical energy output plus increase in stored energy in magnetic field plus energy losses. Okay, this is the energy transfer equation. So for to transfer the energy, we use this equation. Okay, that is electrical energy input from sources, that is input power, is equal to mechanical energy output, that is the energy output or power output, plus increases in stored energy in magnetic field plus energy losses. Okay, this equation we use in the transfer, energy transfer. And coming to the energy balance, we use the same equation, that is electrical energy input from sources, that is equal to mechanical energy output plus increases in stored energy in magnetic field plus energy losses. So for the lossless magnetic energy, store a system in different form, differential form, that is dWe is equal to dWm plus dWf. So for the lossless magnetic energy, store a system in differential form, that is dWe is equal to dWm plus dWf. So that is dWe is equal to I into d into delta, that is the differential change in electric energy input, that is Pin, electric energy input Pin. And dWm is equal to Fm into dx, that is equal to differential change in mechanical energy output. Next, dWf is equal to differential change in magnetic stored energy. dWf is equal to differential change in magnetic stored energy. And coming to the energy in magnetic system, energy in magnetic system. So for that one, we are considering the magnetic system of an attracted armature relay. Attracted armature relay as shown. So this is the diagram we are taking. So in this one, we are taking supply voltage V and resistance, and we are having a coil. It consists of number of turns M, and it consists of EMF E, and it consists of current I, and this coil is connected to the core. Okay, so this core consists of flux, and for that one we are taking one armature relay. Okay, so it consists of hinge and armature and ground connection. That is, we know that the flux linkages of a coil is, we know that the flux linkages of a coil is delta, that is equal to N into phi. Delta, that is equal to N into phi. So here the flux linkage causes a reaction EMF of E, that is equal to d delta by dt. Okay, the flux linkage causes a reaction EMF of E, that is equal to d delta by dt. So from the previous figure, the associated circuit equation is V is equal to IR plus E. V is equal to IR plus E. So that is equal to IR plus E, means you know already that is the flux linkage causes here reaction EMF of, that is here d delta by dt. That is V is equal to IR plus d delta by dt. So the electric energy input into the ideal coil, the electric energy input into the ideal coil due to the flow of current I in time dt is, assuming for the time being that armature is held fixed at position x, all the input energy is stored in the magnetic field. So assuming for the time being that armature is held fixed at position x, all the input energy stored in the magnetic field. Thus, so here the electrical energy input into the ideal coil due to the flow of the current I in time dt is dWe is equal to E into I into dt. And assuming for the time being that the armature is held in fixed rate position x, all the input energy is stored in the magnetic field. Thus, dWe is equal to E into I into dt, that is equal to d into Wf. Okay. So by substituting E value in the above equation, that is dWe is equal to I into d delta, that is equal to F into d phi, that is equal to dWf. Okay, next, the energy absorbed by the magnetic system to establish the flux from initial zero flux is, that is Wf is equal to integral 0 to delta of I of delta into d delta, so that is equal to integral 0 to phi into F of phi of d phi. Okay, the energy absorbed by the magnetic system to establish flux from initial zero flux is Wf is equal to integral 0 to phi, that is equal to F of phi d phi. So the I to delta maximum magnetization curve, which is a configuration variable which x is shown, that is, they give the relationship for various values of x is indicated. That is this diagram. This is the I to delta relationship with variable x. So here the Cartesian diagram is drawn between I to delta. So here I is drawn on the x axis and the delta is taken in the y axis. So here we are drawing three curves by varying the values of x, that is x1, x2, x3 values. So the relation can be expressed. The relation can be expressed as I is equal to I of delta comma x. This is for if delta is the independent variable, or take delta is equal to delta of I comma x, that is, this is for if I is the independent variable. So therefore, the field energy is, therefore, the field energy is in general a function of two variables, that is Wf. So that is equal to Wf of delta comma x, or Wf is equal to Wf of I comma x. Okay, so thus the field energy is determined by the instantaneous values of the system states and independent on the history at any instant. Okay. So, coming to the co-energy and field energy. Coming to the co-energy and field energy. So, for a particular value of air gap length, okay, for a particular value of air gap length, the field energy is represented by the above area between delta axis and delta I characteristics. Okay, for a particular value of air gap length, the field energy is represented by the above area between delta axis and delta to I characteristics. So here the Cartesian diagram, it is shown that the Cartesian diagram between delta axis to I axis. So the delta axis is taken on the y axis and I axis is taken on the x axis. Here the curve is drawn. Okay, it is linearly increasing. Okay, so here we are represented with the curve with the cross marks. One is with the some side cross marks, one is at the vertical cross marks. Okay, so here the side cross marks gives the field energy, that is Wf, and the side cross marks gives the vertical cross marks gives the co-energy, that is Wf conjugate. And the curve, the linear curve is, the increasing curve is drawn, it gives the I to delta curve for fixed x value. Okay, fixed x value. So in this one I am taking the co-energy. So in linear case we are taking L is equal to delta by I. So for the co-energy we are taking, okay, in linear case, but L is equal to delta by I. So then our co-energy can be expressed as, in linear case w dash f is equal to wf, that is equal to 1 by 2 delta I. So but L is equal to, you know already, delta by I. Then our co-energy can be expressed as w dash f is equal to integral 0 to I of delta, that is equal to Li of Li. So that is equal to dI, that is equal to 1 by 2 Li square. Okay, wf dash is equal to integral 0 to I of delta. So here delta is equal to Li from this equation. Okay, so that is Li into dI. So that is equal to half Li square, that is the co-energy. And w dash of wf dash of I comma x is equal to half into L of x into I square. L of x into I square, this is the co-energy. Okay. This is the co-energy and field energy of that one. Okay, thank you. So in this class I discussed about permanent magnet and applications of permanent magnet of this first part of the first unit, that is magnetic material properties and applications. And in the and I started the second part, that is principles of electromagnetic conversion. So in that one I discussed about the introduction, I given introduction to the principles of electromagnetic conversion, and after that I discussed why we need this electromagnetic conversion. And after that I explained the principle and some equations of this electromagnetic conversion. And after that I discussed about co-energy and field energy of this concept. Okay. Thank you for watching this video.